Hi, I'm Jane, an Alto pharmacist specializing in fertility. I'm here to walk through injecting your fertility medications. We'll go through several steps together, so stay tuned. Always make sure your hands are washed and you're working on a clean, flat surface. Let's begin. This version of Leuprolide comes as a kit. It includes one multi-dose vial of Leuprolide 2.8 milliliter solution. It also has 14 0.5 milliliter insulin syringes and some alcohol pads. For this injection, you will need one vial of Leuprolide, one insulin syringe, a few alcohol swabs, a sharps container, and gauze and tissue is optional. If the Leuprolide dose you're injecting is more than 0.5 milliliters or 50 units, such as a trigger dose, you will need a separate 1 milliliter syringe because the ones included in the kit will not hold enough medication for a dose higher than 0.5 milliliters or 50 units. Before we get started, there are a couple of things I wanted to review with you. Examine your medication. Make sure the medication is not expired. Check to ensure there are no cracks on the vial and the solution is clear and does not contain any particles. If you see anything, call your provider or an Alto pharmacist for next steps. To begin, flip off the cap on the vial and wipe the top with an alcohol pad. If you've already used this medication from a previous dose, the cap should already be removed, but you still need to wipe the top with an alcohol pad each time you use it. Unwrap the syringe and remove the cap. Remember, if your dose is 0.5 milliliters or 50 units and less, you can use one of the insulin syringes that comes with the kit. If your dose is higher than 0.5 milliliters or 50 units, use the 1 milliliter syringe provided separately. Pull back the plunger to draw air into the syringe. Fill the syringe with roughly the same amount of air as the amount of medication you've been instructed to take. Place the vial of Leuprolide solution on a hard flat surface and insert the needle straight through the center of the rubber stopper. Slowly press on the plunger to push the air in the syringe into the vial. This step will make it easier to draw up the solution because the vials are pressurized. Invert the vial and pull back the plunger to withdraw the amount of medication you've been instructed to take. When you're pulling liquid out of the vial, make sure the tip of the needle remains submerged in the liquid by slowly backing the needle out of the vial as you withdraw the solution. This will ensure you're drawing up the liquid and not the air inside of the vial. When you are done, flip the vial back and remove the syringe from the vial. This vial of Leuprolide should have more medication than you need. To remove any air bubbles in your syringe, tap on the side of the syringe so the bubbles move to the top. Gently push on the syringe until you see a droplet come out of the tip of the needle. Once you see the droplet, you are ready for your subcutaneous injection. Today, I'll be showing you how to inject in the abdomen because it's the most common location for subcutaneous injection. However, you should check with your doctor or nurse before injecting to ensure you're injecting at the prescribed location. You should inject at or below the level of the belly button, roughly 1 to 2 inches away from the navel. Try not to inject directly below the navel because that area is very vascular and can lead to bleeding and bruising. You should also rotate your injection sites to decrease discomfort. To prepare for your injection, clean the injection site with an alcohol pad and allow the area to air dry. Gently grasp a 2-inch fold of skin between your thumb and index finger at the injection site with your non-dominant hand. Hold the syringe in your dominant hand like a dart and insert the entire length of the needle into the pinched skin at a 90-degree angle. You can insert the needle at a 45-degree angle if you have less fat on your body. Move your index finger over to push down on the plunger in a slow and steady motion until all of the medication is injected. When you're done, release the pinched skin, hold it for a few seconds, and gently withdraw the needle. Lastly, apply light pressure to the injection site with gauze or tissue if there's any discharge. Discard the used needle and syringe into the sharps container. There may be minor bleeding, bruising, or redness around the injection site. you might also see a drop of liquid come out of the injection site after you pull the needle out. All of this is common and should not be of any concern. Let's talk about storage. This version of Leuprolide is generally stored at room temperature, but it can also be stored in the refrigerator due to its wide storage range. Do not freeze the medication. Once it has been punctured, it expires in 28 days. You're done. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, visit alto.com to get in touch with an Alto pharmacist.